Hey, welcome back to another video. If you're new to my channel, hi and welcome. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how I crochet this large size dog sweater. We are going to be using a number 4 medium weight yarn. We are going to begin with a 6.5 millimeter crochet hook. With my first color of yarn, I am going to do a slip knot, and then we will insert our crochet hook and we are going to chain 41. Okay, in the second chain from our hook, we're going to do one half double crochet. We're going to do one half double crochet into each stitch across, ending with a total of 40 stitches. Then we are going, I'm doing my last half double crochet, then I'm going to chain one, and for the next two rows, we're going to do one half double crochet into each stitch across. So that's going to be a total of 40 stitches. That's on rows one that we just completed. Right now I'm on row number two, and then we're also going to do that for row number three. And I'll meet you guys back here when I am done with my third row. Okay, I'm just finishing my last half double crochet. I'm going to chain one, turn my work. Now for row number four, we're gonna do two half double crochets in the first stitch. Then we're gonna do one half double crochet into each stitch across until we meet our last stitch. Okay, and now I'm on my last stitch, so we're gonna do two half double crochets into last stitch. Now we're going to chain one, turn our work, and for the next two rows, we're gonna do one half double crochet into each stitch across, and I'll meet you back here when I am done with row number six and about to start row number seven. Okay, now we are going to chain one, and for row number seven, we are going to do two half double crochets into the first stitch. One half double crochet into each stitch until we meet our last half double crochet. Thank you. Okay, now for our last stitch, we are going to do 2 half double crochets in this last stitch. We are going to chain 1 and do 1 half double crochet into each stitch across. And I'll meet you back here when I am done with row number 8. Okay, I have completed my 8th row. I am doing this sweater in 2 different colors, and I choose to do the different colors in every 8 rows. So I just cut my yarn because I am now going to add in my 2nd color, and I'm doing a dark green. So we are going to slip stitch, chain 1, turn our work, and we're going to do 1 half double crochet into each stitch across. And right now we are on row number 9. We are going to do this for a total of 13 rows. So I will meet you back here after I am done with row number 13. Okay, so I have just completed row number 13. What you want to do is make sure that your starting chain is here, because this is going to help you know that this is the right side of the sweater that should be facing out, and then here is the inside. So really big difference between the two, but if you make sure that this is on the left hand side, that will help you know. And again, it's going to be your odd number stitches ending on here, because row number 1 was our starting row. Anyways, so what we're going to do is we are going to fold our dog sweater over, and I did my last half double crochet. I did not chain, so don't chain. We are going to go into this first half double crochet, and we are going to slip stitch. Now we are going to chain 1, and now we're going to turn our work. We are going to do 1 half double crochet into each stitch around. All right, I'll meet you guys back here when I'm done. Okay, we are going to chain 1, turn our work. We are going to do 1 half double crochet into each stitch around. We are going to chain 1 and turn our work and work the other direction for several rows. At this point, it is very important that we remember to turn our work and work along the front side and the back side. And what that is going to ensure is that right now, we have this V opening. If you just continue to work in the round, your V is not going to match up in the middle of your dog holes up here. It will make the middle of your dog sweater veer off to the side, and this would pretty much end up on the side of your dog's body instead of in the stomach. So really make sure that you chain 1 and you turn your work. So we are going to chain 1, turn our work, work 1 half double crochet into each stitch around. And I think I forgot to say it, but we are doing 44 half double crochets. And then I am going to do this until, so I have my tape measure here, and I am going to do this until I reach 14 inches. And then at 14 inches, which I think it stops at 13 where you guys can see, but for 14 inches, we are going to stop there, and I'm going to show you guys at that row of how to do the dog holes, the leg holes. I will, when I get done and I go to 14 inches, I will let you guys know how many rows I am at. Every time I make a dog sweater, I don't go off of rows anymore. I go off of my measurement of how long it is. But sake for this video, I definitely want you guys to know, if you don't have a tape measure, of just how many rows. So I will let you know that when I come back here. And actually, in editing, I will already type it on the screen.
So do one half double crochet into each row around. Like I said, make sure you chain one and turn your work for each row. I'll meet you guys back here. Okay, I have finished 29 rows. So right now, this is at 14 inches from the bottom of my sweater all the way to where the last row is for the leg holes. Now, depending on how your dog and what size, say that the width around this sweater fits your dog, but maybe your dog isn't as long, you can definitely measure from where you want the sweater to lay by your dog's tail and measure this and stop at any point of the measurement behind your dog's back leg. So pretty much from the tail to behind the front legs of your dog. And that's where you will stop. You do not need to go to this 14 inches. However, if your dog is 19 inches, if you want this dog sweater 19 inches long for your dog, this is a very average measurement to fit that size dog. That's why I go up to 14 inches until the leg holes. So at this point, I am going to chain one and turn our work. We are going to do one half double crochet in the next four stitches. And then we are going to do a chain seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. Okay, so after we do a chain seven, yarn over, and we are going to skip seven half double crochets. So the next seven stitches. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And in the next stitch, we already have our yarn over for our half double crochet. And we are going to do one half double crochet in the next 23 stitches. So there's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, and 23. We are going to chain seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Do our yarn over. We're going to count seven stitches. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Then we are going to do one half double crochet in the next four stitches. So one, two, three, and four. And then we are going to slip stitch. We are going to chain one, turn our work. We are going to do one half double crochet in each stitch around. And then when we get to our leg holes, so this is the first stitch of the leg hole, I just go into only one of the strands because at the end, we will do half double crochets around this leg hole. And it always looks better when I leave the other two strands of this stitch behind when making that half double crochet. So here is, there we go. Okay, so one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, and I have an extra stitch. What did I do wrong? Oops, did I say 23 stitches for the last one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. That is what is wrong. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, I am so sorry. I need to undo this row. I need to go back, and the previous row should have been 4 half double crochets, chain 7, skip 7, and then it should have been 22 stitches, not 23 stitches. And then chain 7, skip 7 stitches, and then 4 half double crochets. So I am going to pause the video here. I'm gonna go back and fix that really quick, and then I'll meet you guys right back here. Okay, so sorry about that. So I have that fixed. I have 40 stitches now. So I just chained one, turn our work, and we're gonna do one half double crochet into each stitch around, and we are going to do this a total of 2 more rows. So this row and one more. I'm gonna pause this video, I'm gonna complete this, and then I will meet you guys back here. Also, I am going to, this is my last row of the green. So if you guys are following me on doing 8 rows for your color, you will, after this row, be done with your dark green. And then we're gonna switch to our orange and do one more row of one half double crochet into each stitch around for one row of the orange. So I will meet you guys back here once I'm done. Okay, so now for our next row, we are going to chain one, yarn over, and we're going to do half double crochet 2 together. So to do a half double crochet, we are going to insert our hook into the first stitch. We're going to yarn over, pull up a loop. We are going to yarn over, insert into the next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. We now have 5 loops on our hook. We are going to yarn over and pull through all 5 loops. Then we are going to do one half double crochet in the next 8 stitches. And then we are going to do another half double crochet 2 together. So again, yarn over, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, and pull through all 5 loops. And again, we are going to do half double crochet 1 in the next 8 stitches. And then we're going to do another half double crochet two together. And then we will do one half double crochet in the next 8 stitches. And then we will do one last half double crochet two together, and then we're just going to do one half double crochet and then slip stitch to our first half double crochet, chain one, turn our work. For this row, we are going to do one half double crochet in the first stitch, and then in the second stitch, we are going to do a front post double crochet. So to do a front post double crochet, we are going to insert into the following stitch in this side, and then we're going to come out the front, and then it's going to go around the post of the stitch. So let me do that one more time. So we yarn over, insert into the next stitch, and then we pull, and then we pull through the front, and then if you see it around the post, not through the stitch, but around the post, and then we are going to yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over, pull through the first 2 loops, yarn over, pull through the last 2 loops. So just like any other double crochet. And then we are going to do a half double crochet in the next. So here's the post, and right in that next stitch after the post, we're gonna do a half double crochet. Okay, and then into the next stitch, so I'm gonna do this one more time. So here is, we go around the post, yarn over, pull through, we have 3 loops. We are going to yarn over, pull through the first 2, yarn over, pull through the last 2. Yarn over, half double crochet into the next stitch. Okay, and we are going to complete this pattern all the way around. And we want to end on a front post double crochet, and it is also very important that we are doing this right now on the outside of the sweater, because if you do this part on the inside, then your collar is not going to have the nice textured look. We also, from this point on, are not going to chain one and turn our work. All of these following rows, we are going to do working on the outside of the sweater. Okay, so and we are going to do this for a total of 4 rows. So after this row, we will continue for 3 more rows. I am keeping you guys on here to show you the very last stitch, and then I am going to pause this. Okay, so here is a front post double crochet, half double crochet, and then our final front post double crochet is right around that last stitch. Okay, so we are going to slip stitch to our first half double crochet, chain one, do a half double crochet into the first stitch, And then we are going to do, now we have these established posts, and now we are going to wrap it directly around the post. And then again, do a half double crochet right next to that. Okay, so here is our next post, and I'm sorry, my dog is dreaming. Okay, I am gonna pause this here and I will meet you guys back here when I am done. So we have a total of 4 of these rows, and we're doing 3 more rows, including this one that I just started. Okay, and for our final row, we are going to chain 1 and we are going to do 1 front post double crochet around every stitch. So around the half double crochets and around the front post double crochets from the previous row. So if you see here, so there is our half double crochet and we just go right around the entire post. Okay, I'm gonna do this and then when I come back here, we are going to do our rows around the V part of the sweater and the leg holes. Okay, I am all done with that. I'm going to cut my yarn and there is that very nice collar and we have that very nice texture. Okay, I am going to go down here to the V and I am going to attach my orange yarn in the orange portion of the sweater. That way when we have our end, we can easily hide it in the orange yarn. And we are going to join with a slip stitch and then just 1 single crochet into each stitch around. And then on our 2 corners, we are going to do 2 single crochets into the corner stitches. So here is, I will demonstrate this corner stitch and then I'm going to pause the video and I will come back here once we move to the leg holes. Okay, so here is the corner stitch and we are just going to do 2 single crochets here to add a nice turn to our sweater. And then again, just 1 single crochet all the way along the back and then back down the side. Okay, so there is the bottom of the sweater. It looks really nice when you do that outline stitch there. Okay, and now for our leg holes, we are going to attach the green yarn with a slip stitch and then 1 half double crochet into each stitch around. And then for the sides, it gets a little tricky, but you will see that there are stitches there because we left that 1 stitch that we did on the leg hole, or the row after the leg hole row. We only went into the 1 strand of yarn, so it left a very nice stitch to complete on this row. So I'm going to go around both of my leg holes and then I will meet you guys back here to show you the end product of what I have here. Okay, here is the dog sweater. It's all done. Here are my nice leg holes. There's the textured collar. And then here is the V, so male dogs can go to the bathroom or it's just nice comfort for them. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please don't forget to hit that like button, comment, and tell me what you think about this video. And I'll see you guys next time.